with number one being the North Lounge Baseball Softball Complex. Right now, the master plan has this going northwest of the existing new soccer complex. It's a five-field club, similar to that, they just built a Freeman Park, not counting the Miracle Field. It would be five 300-foot fields. The North Lounge Park, the trail network, once the baseball softball complex is completed. There's currently a trail network around the skate park. This would be continued on over to the baseball complex and around the soccer complex. There are currently three soccer fields at South Lounge here in Lake Park. That is lighting two of those fields and replacing the baseball, softball fences at South Lounge, installing a new HVAC system at South Lounge, and painting the repairs at South Lounge. Adding playground equipment at State Nation Park, and then, of course, just miscellaneous repairs and painting at various parks as the need arises, or they have current.
The DLPRA has been very good in soliciting Chad's involvement and participation with these projects. You heard me say earlier, reference in the answer to Pierce's question, we have the responsibility of providing these facilities, but we are doing that hand in hand with Parks and Rec so that we meet the needs and their expectations as far as the utilization. And it has been very, very helpful to them to have Chad kind of eyes and ears and feet on the ground as far as working with those contractors and providing interaction with architects, contractors, et cetera. And he also provided that to VLPRA on the tennis courts. That was a kind of city project that Chad worked with in that as well. And so I think you can see where Parks and Rec are going with their concept. And I don't think anybody here was not able to meet with Parks and Rec during their discussions on their long-range plan. Everybody had that opportunity. Right? Now, they have not completed that, as y'all heard me say before. We are anticipating that. I think they said that maybe in April, but they anticipate coming back. Contractor come back to that to evaluate by the authority changes or recommendations that they might make to that. But utilizing that North Lounge facility, South Lounge facility, Freedom Park, and see the north, south, middle section of the county being an emphasis that they are looking to for their primary sports and recreation centers. Any questions on our response?
So do they have a facilities maintenance budget, or is it all just strictly grounds maintenance?
No, they have a grounds and facilities crew. The facilities crew, they receive, I guess he's last name, but him and another guy that look after the facilities. So if they have a need arise, or they need to repaint a building, or they have something they have to hire at us this time, the majority of it is grants. If they have something small, they will do it. Or the grounds crew can handle it, they will do that, but the majority of the time is hired out.
From maintenance issues that can take care of themselves outside of that contract.
So the small maintenance stuff comes out of their budget?
That's right.
And then we pick up?
That's right. The one, when you see the various repairs, that's when, I have some of the South Lambs in there, but for example, if we had to go, it's probably been 10 years ago, we've done the South Lambs. We went in and painted the CMU, all the doors, all the red steel, all the dugouts, you know, pretty significant painting project. They don't have that in that budget. That's where some of this money comes in.
So what about the repairs to North Lambs? I know we had some issues at the skate park with the bathrooms and some of that stuff. Is that all part of the soccer complex?
That's right. The bathrooms were good. The problem we had was the lift station pumps. And some of the new construction of the soccer complex, a new lift station was installed to handle the new soccer complex and those restrooms. And we demolished the existing lift station.
So is the new one up and operational now?
Good.
When they say a citizen or the board decides to take on a different project, say in North Lyons or either South Lyons, it would be after they've completed what they already set to complete already. For instance, like I asked about the pool, you know, another public pool around here somewhere where, you know, he brought up a great suggestion, which was those little water parks, because they don't require maintenance or whatever, they just, they're more sprinkled up. Almost like a lot of Richard made at South Lyons or Splashville or North Lyons and something like that. That would be something that I guess the authority would take on. I mean,
that's right. So in this, some of the projects at North Lyons, one of the items to be considered with the playground equipment is like a little splash.
The splash team, right?
Yes.
The liability issue associated with swimming pool versus those of those splash parks are considered. So I think you'll see the naming of the authority of the sweep park. I think you'll see the naming more towards any water activity being pretty much related to that as opposed to swimming pools. Those are and I think y'all are probably aware that there is a movement of some magnitude by the YMCA to develop an aquatic center on Valdez. They have some property out there, and so how far along that is, I think it's several years away. But they are looking to provide an aquatic center and gymnastics center in that area. And I think it would be very difficult to have competing aquatic centers. Now you have swimming teams and school systems.
Yes,
they
probably
did. They utilize Stone Creek's facility.
So I think you'll see some movement in that direction. Whether or not they add additional swimming pools from parks and
things. I'll add, I have spoken with, also, if you recall back during the, I can't remember which Olympics it was right now, but when they were in Georgia,
yes, it was
'96. Moultrie built an aquatic center over there for the dive, swim, and all that. And it had really become an albatross around their neck over there, just from the standpoint of maintenance, because it's aged now and it's got to be redone and refinished. And so it's a very expensive recreational resource to have. It's one of the owners of private pool knows that they're expensive to operate. And so that was a commercial basis.
It's not like the splash park probably the best deal, if we can get the different parks around here, we got the maintenance, we did, and lash it and sprinkle whatever, it's not that big and all that. Any questions on?
Yeah, are there any plans, and if not, can we make plans to do something about our boat ramps on the Withlacoochee River?
There are.
We have that, we got a map of boat ramps and we'll be ready to talk about that.
That's.
There's opportunity.
That is for work.
But.
Let me go ahead and give you an update from the standpoint of Parks and Rec. It is in the process of having communication with DNR over those boat ramps. Now, if y'all recall, I asked several of you, and you said, we want to do something about the boat ramps. My question was, to what degree? Is that to the level of upgrading that we did at Naylor? The issue that George is discussing with DNR is improving or creating those ramps. It certainly wouldn't be the amount of land, including the land that we retain. But I think one of the requirements, and Chad said it on that meeting, was that you have to have access from an all-weather road. So at least one of our programs in the south end may be prohibited because of the distance on that all-weather road.
Did you speak to Nacken?
Knightsbury.
Knightsbury.
Oh, it's a dirt road.
I understand that, but what we have in place, we just need to improve on and see that Parks and Rec, who should be over that, correct? Maintain it and keep it up. Like
well,
we were saying.
And I'm not saying that the fact that Nacken would not be eligible for the DMR would mean that we would not approve it. It just means that it would not fall under that DNR funding, and DNR would not accept the responsibility of the major maintenance. So I think you can leave here knowing that it is in the plans by Parks and Rec, and certainly expressed here by the county, that all of these boat ramps, certainly those three, are scheduled for improvement.
That's right. So, in speaking with Bert Deaner with the DNR and Bay Cross, what they do is enter into a lease agreement between BLPRA/Highlands County and the state. At that time, we have, before it used to have to be legislative funds approved for that. Now they have, with the additional funds to the license, and then what they have, it's called GOSA funds. They have money available now. They're actually fixing to do some repairs. I talked to them this morning at 31 in the coming weeks. George currently has the lease agreement. He's going to bring it to the county because these properties that BLPRA ceases to exist, and the properties go back to Lowndes County. So we would be in the lease agreement with them for the county commission's approval. And what they do is they come in, they spend the funding on the ramps only. And they would, if the ramp needs to be replace it. If it needs a section replaced, they do that. Or if it just needs some curves and steps, they may do that. But that is the BLPRA would continue with the maintenance of the parking area and the trash and informing them of anything wrong
three boat ramps that we're discussing, based on the terrain, would not require the rocks and so forth on the side of the slope of that in order to prevent erosion. So it won't be a cost as large as the neighbors.
While we're speaking of the rivers and boat ramps, where are we on this Fruitvale River camp? Are we supporting that theory? The Fruitvale River camp has been...
What's with the chairman? You signed the letter.
I sent a letter in support of the project. However, I did not commit any funding.
Right, well, I knew that.
And that, so that's where we're at with it from the county standpoint.
Chad, you have that.
Yeah, so some of the staff was able to help a few numbers and all, and I'm mistaken, the grant was not approved at this year. I understand they're going to go back for that grant next year.
Okay, just wanted to know where we were.
Any other questions? Any other questions? Chair, would you go back to the just to have a brief update on existing loss seven.
So just behind Harrison's revenue report, there's two pages there that are loss seven. Okay.
So in squash seven, nearly all the projects are complete. Two of them we've just covered in squash eight report, which was the animal shelter and the courthouse. The only other item left is the drill field improvements and another fire station for renovation. The drill field improvement, the main thing we had was the drafting pit. In the last few months, staff was able to find a mobile drafting pit. We staff in-house and designed one that's permanent in the arena. We found at a conference a mobile drafting pit, so it can be taken from one station to another, depending on where training is. We do training on Monday nights or on Saturdays. It falls within our budget, so that's one of the things that we're considering. Mr. Pritchard, and looking at it, it's really a, seems like a better idea than just having a single drafting pit in the ground. The other thing is some minor repairs to Station 10. Well, some renovations, we've already completed the repairs. We'll be doing some cosmetic work with that money. And that would be the only items left to complete was Floss 7. Other than the money that was moved to SWAT.
Will you go through the 911 cut back to the most referenced earlier, what we typically at 911 and SWAT State? Just
so, session, SWAT 7, the main part of the project is we added, expanded the building to the east. And added a operations area. Before, for the operators, there was no area for them to go. There was no offices for some of the administration for operations. So we added those areas, which included two offices, a quiet room, a shower, and a break room for operations. Then in the main operations area, we were able to replace the current furniture, of course, y'all approved that, with the new consoles, that allowed for better posture, better comfort within that facility, as they are there 12 hours a day, as well as we renovated everything but those four offices, as far as new carpet, new paint, removing.
Are you talking about that one?
Yes, sir.
Out of SWAT 7.
That is, sir.
I'm
That was everything that was completed in slot seven, was the one we had for that.
Any questions on any of the slots projects?
Is, Chad, have you seen any, much usage out of the Mayla Community Center?
I haven't spoken with them about that. I do know they do use it. I can find out.
Will you update them on the tile four?
Yes. So when Steve at Parks and Rec called us several months back, and we had 41 tiles that were broken, and what we found was the expansion, those tiles were laid over the expansion joint. So we took those up and treated that expansion joint. And then we had a few in the back rooms where the tile extra stalls were, went into the tile, a few of those cracked, but we got those fixed and got some correct brackets. So that's what happened.
Is that tile?
Yes, sir.
It's ceramic tile.
Yes, sir.
Have you considered that plank floor?
Yes, we have, because we've actually used that in a couple other spots, and that'd be one of the things to look at, like with the Plotville Community Center.
So basically, the tile is broken.
Yes, sir. It was a special expansion. It was a straight, solid expansion going to the concrete all the way through the building.
Would that plank floor not have the same problem?
Yeah. Well, depending on the material we use. Mm-hmm. What we'll do now is we'll make sure that joint's treated and the concrete before we do anything. Live and learn from some of those. And we will make sure that it's taken care of. So no matter what we use, we're not affected by that.
If you use the same concrete floor kind of like this, and you've never seen it before, the expansion joint would have been in that.
That's right.
Anything else for Chad? Any questions? Clay has needed to step out to participate in a conference call with y'all's approval. I'd like to hire